What's up, guys? Welcome back to the third episode of the Moth Podcast. I'm joined here with
Ryan, and we're going to talk about the NFL season recap, the free agents with Deshaun Watson, Dak Prescott, J.J. Watt, and where they have signed or they might be going.
First, we're gonna start with the NFL. I mean, we haven't had a podcast since like in a really long time, since like way before the season even started. So we've pretty much missed the entire season. But kind of like review, like what happened and who won the awards and breakout players, surprising teams and stuff. First, I guess we can talk about the Bucks winning the Super Bowl.
Yes, Tom Brady, the GOAT. They were all probably the Super Bowl favorites in the NFC with the Packers. Came down to a very controversial game, the NFC Championship, but their performance in the Super Bowl, they definitely deserve to win.
The Chiefs repeating, going back to the Super Bowl, and Mahomes kind of got stranded. Aaron Rodgers won MVP. That wasn't really that much of a surprise as the season went on. Henry won Offensive Player of the Year. That wasn't really a surprise either. She had 2,000 yards. Offensive Player of the Year was Donald. That definitely isn't a surprise. Pretty much wins it every year.
He's going to be the best defensive player of all time whenever he retires.
Offensive Rookie of the Year. A lot of people weren't happy about Justin Herbert, which I think he deserved it.
Quarterback's more valuable than a wide receiver.
Jefferson's had a really good year, though. He like broke the receiving yards record. And then Defensive Rookie of the Year was Chase Young, which I guess he deserved it.
Chin got snubbed. A lot of people. Chin deserved it, but you know.
And Gross Matos is in that conversation.
Gross Matos, the biggest snub for MVP, Defensive Player of the Year, and Defensive Rookie of the Year. He's gonna have buttocks.
Comeback Player of the Year, Alex Smith. That wasn't a surprise either, especially as soon as he actually started playing and led them to the playoffs, it kind of like solidified it. Coach of the Year was Stefanski. Browns kind of turned them around, got them a playoff win.
Teams that flopped like the 49ers.
Yeah, Vikings, Chargers couldn't hold. Chargers and Falcons both couldn't hold leads like usual.
Joke artists, clowns.
Saints disappointed in the playoffs, not a surprise. The NFC East was hot garbage. Cowboys disappointed. Raiders actually did fall off in the second half of the season.
Yeah, they started 6-3, had the easiest remaining schedule, and missed the playoffs.
All right, so starting with the free agency, we're gonna start with J.J. Watt, which that news actually just came out today, so some pretty fresh insights we're about to give. It seemed like, obviously, like, I'm pretty sure everybody in the Texans hates the organization, but it seemed like he wanted to go, it seemed like he wanted a ring, basically. Like, he didn't want the money, because he could have got money pretty much anywhere he wanted, but I thought that he wanted a ring, so, like, I thought he's going to go to, like Buffalo, Green Bay, Pittsburgh with his brothers there, Cleveland, like good teams. I could still pay him like decent money maybe, but more so about the rings. But he signed with the Cardinals, so that's kind of dumb in my opinion, going to the hardest division. So I guess it was just clear that he wanted money more than a ring.
Had a back half of his career, he probably just wants some accomplishments. I didn't really understand the decision. I mean, the Cardinals aren't even like a bad team, but they're not Super Bowl ready for at least a couple years.
And he's also in like he has a 2-year $31 million contract, and $23 million is guaranteed. I mean, the Cardinals are gonna have like kind of a gross defense now, because they're gonna have Chandler Jones, J.J. Watt on the line, and then still Buda Baker back there. They have Isaiah Simmons.
They re-signed Theo Riddick.
If they can get a lockdown corner, they can make like a next step sort of. And then Deshaun Watson, you can go first.
Deshaun Watson, well, obviously he's demanded a trade from the Texans because their organization is just a mess. And Texans right now, they are saying that he's not up for trade. They're denying all trade talks. They're not taking calls from any teams. But it's pretty clear that he wants out of Houston. He doesn't want to stay there. Notable teams that Watson because in his contract he has a no trade clause, so he has to accept the trade from the teams. He said he would accept the Panthers, 49ers, and Jets so far. Those are his three main teams he wants to go to. We'll wait to see what happens with the Texans, if they decide to open up trade talks or not, but right now, yeah, they really want to keep him, so we'll try to see what happens with that.
We had a we also had a post about it for our Instagram account, at MXTH.football, about Sean Watson going to the Panthers, like rumors and like possibilities with that, so you should check that out if you want. We'll...
In my opinion, Panthers would be the best fit. Great offense, got a young rising defense, not the heart of a division. Would be a perfect fit. But if you want to see more football content outside this podcast, go follow the Moth Football account.
Yeah, we're going to have a lot more content on there. All right, so next is Dak wanting to get paid as much as Mahomes, which sounds pretty stupid. Obviously, he like means a lot to the Cowboys and like the city or whatever, but like as shown with like after what happened after he got injured last season, but I mean, he's not worth like more than $30 million a year. So yeah, I don't really think there's any way Dak staying in Dallas unless like Zeke and like D-Law and a bunch of those players start restructuring or even like cutting some people.
Take pay cuts.
So free agency in general, we have there's actually a stacked free agency like player pool. So I mean, there's like tons of wide receivers. I mean, Allen Robinson, Chris Godwin, Will Fuller, Kenny Golladay, Juju, T.Y. Hilton, Marvin Jones, Corey Davis. I mean, there's just tons of wide receivers that are going to be going
around. And if you
want
to see our in-depth predictions, you can go to the Moth account. It's all on there and more football content.
Running backs, Aaron Jones, Chris Carson, Kenyon Drake, Marlon Mack, Philip Lindsay, Leonard Fournette, Mike Davis. The salary cap being lowered is also going to have a big effect too, so these people that are going to be wanting a lot of money aren't going to necessarily get what they want. A lot more information and stuff on our Moth Football account, so you should definitely check it out. We'll have a bunch of stuff coming
out. We'll probably
make
more predictions after the draft, because that will probably dictate
we'll have a bunch of draft
what
stuff too.
Teams go for. That'll be big right there.
Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave your predictions and thoughts in the comments. Be sure to check out our Instagram at mxth.football. And hopefully we'll see you in the next podcast.
Thanks for watching.
Baby, tell me, how did you get so cold enough to chill my